10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 0. Liftoff of the mighty Delta IV Heavy rocket with NASA's Parker Solar Probe.
So 12 months ago, you stood on the balcony at Kennedy Space Center and you watched a rocket. Was that the first time you had ever seen a rocket launch?
In person, it's the first time I've seen it. And I realized there's the up-close video with all the fire and the fury of the launch pad. But it's just as exciting to see it from 6 miles away, because you get a feeling then for the great distances that are involved. I was very moved by the fact that that spacecraft is going off into the night sky and he'll never come back. Sort of sad, you know.
I had separation anxiety because after working with that spacecraft for so long, she became part of the team, and to say goodbye to her was really, really tough.
And always a little anxiety about, will something go wrong?
Yes.
And the answer is no. This baby was built to perform and it's done its job flawlessly.
She certainly has. It was just an amazing experience to stand and see the spectacle of the launch, and also realize that the person who'd really inspired the entire project was sitting right in front of me. Gene Parker was the one who really figured out how all of the energy and all of the excitement that goes on in the sun is really carried to us here at Earth, right the way out to the very edge of our heliosphere.
Well, I'm delighted to be out here to tell you a little bit about what Parker Solar Probe has been doing since the launch 1 year ago.
We have completed 2 full orbits of the sun. So we did our first Venus flyby just a few weeks after she launched, and then straight into the sun. So far, she is behaving beautifully. We are very happy we've managed to bring down at least twice as much data as we had originally suspected from those first 2 perihelion passes. I brought some data to show you.
Oh.
This was our first light image from the Whisper camera. And this is actually the Milky Way.
Okay.
And I know we're supposed to be looking at the sun, but this is my favorite image. This is close to the sun. And you can see there's a couple of little flux ropes here. Mm-hmm. And you cannot see those from the Earth or anything that is close to the Earth.
All I can say is, wow. And I'm not surprised that it's strange, because it usually is when you go there and make measurements. Wouldn't be surprised if the most surprising things have yet to come. I wonder what an elementary textbook will say, let's say 10 years from now.
Yes, I'm sure they will change. I'm sure we will rewrite textbooks because of this mission, and because we're finally going to explore the kind of outer atmosphere of the star. It's very exciting.
It isn't over yet.
1 year in, we have another 6 to go.
Yeah.